محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. حي على الصلاة.
اللهم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم.
حي على الصلاة. حي على الفلاح. حي على الفلاح.
الحمد لله، الحمد لله فاطر الوجود من العدم، وجاعل النور من الظلم، ومخرج الصبر من الألم، وملقي التوبة على الندم. فنشكره على المصائب كما نشكره على النعم، ونصلي ونسلم على رسوله الأكرم ذو الشرف الأشم والنور الأتم والكتاب المحكم، خير ولد آدم، الذي بشر به عيسى ابن مريم، ودعا لبعثته إبراهيم عليه السلام حين يرفع قواعد بيت الله المحرم. فنصلي ونسلم ونبارك على سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا محمد صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. إن أصدق الحديث كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد بن عبد الله، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أوصيكم وإياي بتقوى الله وحسن عبادته. All praise is due to Allah, the most gracious, the most merciful, and peace and blessings be upon His last and final messenger. He who Allah guides will never be misguided, and he who Allah misguides will never be guided. We begin today's khutbah with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba being invited to a meal. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the shoulder was brought to him. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam loves the shoulder, the meat of the shoulder. He says, فَنَكَسَ مِنْهَا نَكْسَةً. He took a bite of the shoulder and said, أَنَا سَيِّدُ الْخَلْقِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I am the best of creation on the Day of Judgment. And he asked the Sahaba, أَتَدْرُونَ لِمَاذَا? Do you know why I'm the best of creation on the Day of Judgment? He says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala yajma'u al-awwalina wal-akhirina fi sa'idin wahid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gathers the people from Adam all the way to Yawm al-Qiyamah on one plane. All of us together. فَيَبْصِرُهُمْ النَّظَرُ وَيَسْمَعْهُمُ الدُّعَاءُ وَتَدُونُ مِنْهُمُ الشَّمْسِ وَتَدُونُ مِنْهُمُ الشَّمْسِ. He puts them all on one plane. Everyone can see one another. Everyone can hear one another. And the sun comes closer to our heads. And he says, from the difficulty and the stress and the difficulty of that day, they begin to talk to one another. And they say, do you not see what situation we are in? We need to find a solution. We need to find someone to intercede for us. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can begin the hisab. So they say, فَعَلَيْكُمْ بِآدَمْ. Go to Sayyidina Adam. أبو البشر. So they come to Sayyidina Adam. And they say, يَا آدَمْ أَنْتَ أَبُو الْبَشَرْ خَلَقَكَ اللَّهُ بِيَدَيْهِ ونفخ فيك من روحه وأمر الملائكة فسجدوا لك وأسكنك الجنة ألا تشفع لنا إلى ربك؟ O Adam, you are the father of all mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you with his own two hands. And he commanded the angels to prostrate for you. Can you not ask your Lord to just begin? Can you not intercede for us just to begin with Yawm al-Hisab? Sayyidina Adam responds, إِنَّ رَبِّي قَدْ غَضِبَ الْيَوْمَ غَضَبًا لَمْ يَغْضَبْهُ قَبْلًا وَلَنْ يَغْضَبْهُ بَعْدًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry on this day. He has never been this angry before and he will never be this angry ever again. And he says, وَإِنِّي أَكَلْتُ مِنَ الشَّجَرَةِ And I ate from the tree. نفسي نفسي. I ate from the tree, I committed a sin. Myself. اذهبوا إلى غيري. Go to someone else. Leave me alone. اذهبوا إلى نوح. So this group goes to Sayyidina Nuh. And they say, Ya Nuh, أنت أول الرسل إلى أهل الأرض. وقد سماك الله عبدا شكورا. O Nuh, you were the first messenger Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to earth. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala testified that you are a thankful servant. Will you not intercede for us? Will you not ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to begin Yawm al-Qiyamah, to begin the Hisab? He says, إِنَّ رَبِّي قَدْ غَضِبَ الْيَوْمَ غَضَبًا لَنْ يَغْضَبُ قَبْلَهُ وَلَنْ يَغْضَبُ بَعْدَهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry on this day. He has never been this angry before and he will never be this angry after. And he says, وَإِنِّي قَدْ كَانَتْ لِي دَعْوَةً دَعَوْتُ بِهَا عَلَىٰ قَوْمِي نَفْسِي نَفْسِي. And I made a dua on my qawm, on my people. نَفْسِي نَفْسِي. Myself. I can't help anyone. I'm helping myself. اذهبوا إلى غيري اذهبوا إلى إبراهيم. This is the day of judgment. So this group go with Sayyidina Ibrahim alayhi salam. And they say, يا إبراهيم أنت نبي الله وخليله من أهل الأرض اشفع لنا إلى ربك ألا ترى إلى ما نحن فيه. O Ibrahim, you are the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And his companion on this earth, Sayyidina Ibrahim is known as the companion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Khalilur Rahman. You see the situation that we are in. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to begin the hisab. Sayyidina Ibrahim responds, إِنَّ رَبِّي قَدْ غَضِبَ الْيَوْمَ غَضَبًا لَمْ يَغْضَبْ قَبْلَهُ مِثْلَهُ وَأَنْ يَغْضَبْ بَعْدَهُ مِثْلَهُ. Just like the other two, Sayyidina Ibrahim responded. Truly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry on this day. Never has he been this angry and never will he be this angry. وَإِنِّي كُنْتُ قَدْ كَذَبْتُ ثَلَاثَ كَذَبَاتٍ And I've made three lies in my life. نَفْسِي نَفْسِي. Myself. اذهبوا إلى غيري اذهبوا إلى موسى. Go to Sayyidina Musa. Maybe he can help you. Says يا موسى أنت رسول يا موسى فضرق الله برسالاته وبكلامه على الناس اشفع لنا إلى ربك ألا ترى إلى ما نحن فيه. O Musa, you are a prophet and a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah spoke to you directly. Can you not intercede for us, for Allah to start the hisab? Sayyidina Musa says just like the previous, إِنَّ رَبِّي قَدْ غَضِبَ الْيَوْمَ غَضَبًا Truly my God is angry, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry today. An anger that he has never been angry before. An anger that he will never be angry again. And I killed someone. unintentionally, but I have killed someone. نفسي نفسي. Myself, myself. اذهبوا إلى غيري, اذهبوا إلى عيسى. So they go to Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. And he says, أنت رسول الله. وكلمته ألقاه إلى مريم وروح منه. وكلمت الناس في المهد. اشفع لنا إلى ربك. Oh Sayyidina Isa, you are a prophet and a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave birth to you without any assistance. And you spoke in your infancy. Will you not ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to intercede for us? Will you not intercede for us so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can begin hisab? Sayyidina Isa responds just like the previous. إن ربي قد غضب اليوم غضبا. Truly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is angry today. An anger that he has never been and an anger that he will never be again. And Sayyidina Isa doesn't even mention a sin. He says nafsi nafsi. Before I continue the rest of the hadith, I want us to understand who these people are. These are not just anbiya and not just rusul. These are ulil azmi min ar-rusul, the best people to set foot on this earth are these five individuals after the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And Sayyidina Adam talked about a sin that we are certain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already forgiven him for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has forgiven Sayyidina Adam. Yet the difficulty of that day, Sayyidina Adam is so scared. Nafsi, myself, myself. I'm not helping anyone except myself. Because of the difficulty of that day. Sayyidina Nuh was calling to his people for 950 years just da'wah. That's not including his life and the normal worship that he had. 950 years just doing da'wah to his people. Nafsi, nafsi. Sayyidina Ibrahim, three lies, ثلاثة كذبات. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم said, كلها في ذات الله. All of them were for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to prove a point for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Every single one of us lie three times an hour. Three times in his entire life. Nafsi, nafsi, myself, myself. Sayyidina Isa doesn't even mention a sin. Nafsi, nafsi. If this is the situation of ulil azm min ar-rusul, what is the situation of the rest of the prophets? What is the situation of the salihin? What is going to be our situation? The ones who know we have transgressed against ourselves. The ones who can't count our sins. What is our situation going to be? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So they go to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He says, يا محمد أنت رسول الله وخاتم النبيين قد غفر الله ما تقدم من ذنبك وما تأخر اشفع لنا إلى ربك. Oh Muhammad, you are the prophet and messenger and the last of messengers. Please go and intercede for us in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam goes and intercedes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he says, ثم يفتح الله علي من محامده وحسن الثناء عليه شيئا لم يفتحه على أحد قبلي. He praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a way that is befitting. And he prostrates before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ارفع رأسك سل تعطى اشفع تشفع. Oh Muhammad, raise your head. Get off of prostration. Ask, you will be given. وَأَشْفَعْ تُشَفَّعْ. Intercede and you will be interceded for. And the first thing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, أُمَّتِي يَا رَبِّ أُمَّتِي يَا رَبِّ. يا يا رب أمتي. Us. The Prophet interceded for us. He interceded for us صلى الله عليه وسلم. And another narration, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم goes in even more detail. He specifies what he asked for from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says, Ya Rabbi, he says, Ya Rabbi, Ummati, Ummati. فيقول سبحانه وتعالى انطلق فأخرج منها من كان في قلبه مثقال شعيرة من إيمان. Go, O Muhammad, and take everyone that has a rice grain of Iman and put them to Jannah. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam returns a second time and praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way he ought to be praised. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, again, he says, Ya Muhammad, ارفع رأسك وكل يسمع لك واسأل تعطى واشفع تشفع. O Muhammad, raise your head. Ask and you will be given. Intercede and you will be interceded for. And again, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for the second time. أمتي يا رب. يا رب أمتي أمتي. My ummah, my people, us. Us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, انطلق فاخرج منها من كان في قلبه مثقال ذرة أو خردل من إيمان. Go, O Muhammad, and take everyone that has a mustard seed of Iman and put them into Jannah. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam returns again for the third time. And he praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way he ought to be praised. And again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, Ya Muhammad, ارفع رأسك واسأل تعطى واشفع تشفع. O Muhammad, raise your head. Ask and you will be given, intercede and you will be interceded for. He says, أمتي أمتي. My ummah, again for the third time. My ummah, my ummah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, انطلق فاخرج من كان في قلبه أدنى 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 مثقال حبة خردل من إيمان. The smallest, smallest, smallest atoms weight of Iman, take them out of the hellfire and put them into Jannah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam didn't stop there. He goes for a fourth time. He comes to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and he prostrates and praises Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the way he ought to be praised. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again, he says, Ya Muhammad, ارفع رأسك واشفع تشفع. O Muhammad, raise your head. Ask and you will be given. Intercede for anyone and you will be interceded for. And again, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says, Ya رب أمتي, Ya رب أمتي. My people, us, everyone in this room. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فأقول يا رب إئذلني في من قال لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. So Allah subhanahu, he says, Oh Allah, allow me to intercede for anyone that has said لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. فيقول الله سبحانه وتعالى وعزتي وجلالي وكبريائي وعظمتي لأخرجن منها من قال لا إله إلا الله. الله سبحانه وتعالى says by my majesty and my glory I will take out of the hellfire من قال whoever says لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. So I testify, أشهد, and every single one of us, inshallah, will say لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be amongst those that say لا إله إلا الله محمد رسول الله in this life and the hereafter. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا إنه الغفور الرحيم. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. Why did I begin my khutbah in this fashion today? Earlier this week, our brothers and sisters in humanity had their annual Thanksgiving, a time for them to be thankful. And this concept of shukr and hamd and thankfulness in general is something that is ingrained in our religion. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling us, وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نَعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. And if you were to count the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you would not be able to comprehend. Amongst the biggest blessings for all of us is that we are of the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That we are of the people of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And this is a blessing that many of us take for granted. And many of us forget to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He has given us the honor and the privilege to be in this ummah. But the question becomes, how do we show our gratitude to Allah and His Messenger for being in this ummah? First and foremost, our homework. How we're going to change our ilm to amal is we're going to praise the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam the way we were commanded to praise him sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala في القرآن العظيم يقول إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His angels pray on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. O you who believe, inshallah, every single one of us, praise the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So every opportunity that we get, every moment that we have that we remember, the blessing of being in the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we will salli alayhi salatu wasalam. Number two is by showing gratitude in al-amal. In kuntum tuhibbuna Allah fattabi'uni ahbabkum Allah. Truly you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, follow me, follow the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I'malu ala Dawood shukra. Act. You want to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that you're of the ummah of Muhammad. Act the way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us to act. See in our lives where the sunnah can be followed and implement the sunnah. How can we call ourselves the ummah of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when we know nothing about him? When we don't follow any of his teachings, how can we expect him to intercede for us? Or hope that he'll intercede for us? Or want for him to intercede for us? If we don't follow any of his sunan, if we follow none of his teachings. So this week we're going to find one sunnah. We're going to learn one sunnah. And we're going to make that our goal for the week. This sunnah I'm going to follow consistently every single day for this week and allow it to be part of my life. And I pray and let that sunnah be between you and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And make the intention that this sunnah is going to be the sunnah that I say, oh Messenger of Allah, this is how I am part of your ummah. This is how I followed your sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Number three, many a times we forget how long and difficult the Day of Judgment will be. Many of us don't talk about the Day of Judgment frequently enough. So I wanted to take this opportunity to remind us, no matter what struggle, no matter what difficulty, no matter what challenge we are going through, is ever so small in the difficulty and the challenge of Yawm al-Qiyamah. So don't allow this difficulty to consume your life to the point where you forget your obligations to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where you forget to follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So allow yourself to remind every single day before you sleep, today might be my last. How will I do better if I wake up tomorrow morning? How will I change my life? If tomorrow is يوم القيامة, what will I have wished I had done differently? And do it right away, right now. And lastly, show gratitude. من لا يشكر الناس لا يشكر الله. Show gratitude to the people around you. Show gratitude to everyone around you. Show gratitude to your parents, your friends. And this is a teaching of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is how we follow the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allow us to be amongst those that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam intercedes for on the Day of Judgment. Allahumma hdina fi man hadayt, wa'afina fi man afayt, wa'tawallana fi man tawallayt. Allahumma hdina wahdi bina waj'alna sababan liman ihtada. Allahumma hdina wahdi bina waj'alna sababan liman ihtada. عباد الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واستغفروه يغفر لكم وأقم الصلاة. عبد الرحمن تعال من فضلك. تعال.
الله أكبر الله